Welcome back to Electron Devices and Circuits lecture video series. In this video, we are going to discuss about the topic Zener as a Regulator, Part 1. At the end of the video, you will be able to understand what is voltage regulator, different types of voltage regulator, and operation of voltage regulator. Let's go into the topic. So first one is voltage regulator. So from the name itself, what is voltage regulator? So regulator in the sense, it maintains a constant output voltage regardless of the changes in the input and on the changes in the load side. So a device that maintains a constant voltage at the output is called as an voltage regulator. So this voltage regulators will be looking like this. It is having a three leads. One lead is for input and an output side, and third lead is for common side. This may be you got it while purchasing the regulator from the shop. You will get a specification sheet from that you came to know. So, and the different types of voltage regulator is Zener diode, shunt regulator, and transistor shunt regulator, transistor series regulator, controlled transistor series regulator, transistor current regulator, op amp series regulator, op amp shunt regulator, switching regulators, and monolithic regulators. So in this sense, in all the cases you are using a Zener diode, whereas in the second and third one you are using additionally transistor. Transistor is a new term for you. I will tell you in detail while we are discussing this topic. And the fourth one is controlled transistor series regulator. We can able to control some parameters at the output of transistor, and at the same times it can act as a regulator. And transistor current regulator. And the next one is op-amp series regulator, shunt regulator. Instead of using a transistor here, we are using operational amplifier. This is an IC based device. It is having an n number of application. So by using op-amp, how can we design a regulator? That is these things. And then switching regulators and monolithic regulators, we'll see. So first one, the Zener diode shunt regulator. So Zener diode shunt regulator in the sense, shunt means what? What is a shunt? Shunt is nothing but it is a parallel. So regulator, Zener diode shunt regulator. You know, Zener diode is acting as a regulator. If the diode is connected in shunt with the load or parallel with the load, it is called Zener shunt regulator. You know, Zener operates in which bias? We are using Zener diode in which bias? Forward bias or reverse bias? We are using in reverse bias only, because in the reverse bias breakdown region only Zener diode operates. So we are using in reverse bias only. So this circuit is the reverse biasing circuit. See here, positive terminal of the source is connected to negative terminal of the diode, and negative of the source is connected to positive terminal of the diode. So this is reverse bias. This circuit you know. And see here, additionally what we have connected is the load resistance is connected in parallel with the load. The load resistance is connected in parallel to the Zener diode. So these two are in parallel, and hence the name Zener diode shunt regulator. And the output voltage is tapped across the load resistance RL. Right, and the current flowing through it is IS. Let us abbreviate the terms. VS is the source voltage, and RS is the series resistance. IS is the current flowing through the series resistance. VZ is the Zener diode, and V0 is the output voltage. IZ is the diode current, and IL is the load current, and RL is the load resistance. So with respect to this diagram, you say that input is nothing but, what is the input here? Unregulated voltage. Unregulated voltage means the voltage that is having a lot of variations is called unregulated. Amplitude is having lot of ups and downs, that is called as an unregulated voltage. We want to convert that voltage into a constant DC voltage, that is called as an regulated voltage. If we want to do this, we have to use a Zener diode. That is the condition. So in this case, what is the current IL? So what I told you, this diode and this load resistance are in parallel. You know, any device connected in parallel, the voltage remains constant. So what is the voltage across V0? That is RL, this is V0. So voltage across RL is V0, IL is the current, RL is the resistance. So from this I can find the current IL is equal to V0 divided by RL. This is simply by Ohm's law. So you know this V0 is same as that of the voltage across the Zener diode VZ. Here in this arm only one Zener diode is there. It is having an voltage of VZ. These two are in parallel. So automatically we can say that VZ is equivalent to V0. So replace this VZ, sorry V0 by VZ, you will get this value. This is equivalent to constant. IL has to be maintained constant. Once if this current is constant, then only the output voltage becomes constant. If either if this current or if this resistance is varying, the output voltage is keep on varying. So we should not want that. We don't want that. So actually we have to maintain constant output voltage. So when the breakdown occurs, for that what we have to do, if we want to maintain output voltage constant, we have to use the device in the breakdown region. So we have to operate the diode in the breakdown region, then only we will get V0 is equal to VZ. So here we will discuss the operation of a shunt diode under two cases. So one case is what? By varying the input source voltage VZ, unregulated voltage is varying. If there is changes in VS, how V0 is maintaining constant? This is one case. And second case is, if there is a changes in load resistance, how V0 is maintaining constant? So actually our target is that only. Whatever may be the changes, either in the input side or on the load side, output voltage has to maintain constant. For that we have to use the Zener diode. So that is the problem we are having. So let us see how the Zener diode is capable of maintaining these things. So we'll go to the first case. So first case is regulation with varying input voltage. See here, the input voltage is considered as a variable voltage. RS is the, you know, all these things are same. And IL is the current flowing. Here RL is fixed. Right, when the source is varying, load is assumed to be fixed. It's assumed to be fixed. So in this case, how we can analyze means, if there is any changes in the input voltage, before that you keep one thing in mind. So this is the incoming current, here some junction is there, so current gets divided. So once if the current divided, how it is flowing? Here the current is coming here and here it is dividing like this. Here IZ and here IL. So I can say the total current I is equal to IZ plus IL. Can I write like this? By Kirchhoff's current law, I can write like this. So this is at any instant of time, this needs to be equal. So here what is happening means, if input voltage increases, what happens? Current automatically increases. If this I increases, automatically this IZ and IL has to be increased. This term has to be increased. This is nature. If this increases, automatically this has to be increases. But what is the constraint here means, RL is fixed. If resistance is fixed, the current flowing through that line is also fixed. So IL does not able to change. So if this increase in I is compensated only by the increase in the IZ. So IZ has to increase proportionally so that this has to compensate for the increase in I. Right, this is the case. So how long this IZ can able to increase? So IZ can see this diagram. So IZ reverse characteristics. IZ can be able to increase only up to IZ maximum. It can't able to increase beyond this. Once if it increase beyond this value, it comes out of the breakdown region. So we cannot use this Zener diode. So as long as IZ is less than IZ maximum, VZ is constant. So this is one condition. If V increases, I increases. I increases, IL cannot increase because RL is constant. So this increase is compensated by the increase in IZ. This increase in IZ is limited only up to IZ maximum. So this is the condition. And the next one, if there is any decrease in VL, the reverse things happen. If a VN decreases, I decreases, this term has to get decreased. If this term decreases, if this term has to decrease means IL cannot decrease because RL is constant. So this decrease is compensated only by the decrease in IZ. How long the IZ can decrease? IZ can decrease only up to IZ minimum. if it decreases till this value, I Z minimum, if I Z decreases below I Z minimum, it comes out of the breakdown. See here, this region, it comes out of the breakdown region, so the diode cannot operate in the breakdown region. So this is the condition here. IZ should be always greater than IZ minimum. So the current flowing through the diode should be always maintained between these limits. So it should be greater than IZ minimum and less than IZ maximum. Then only this reverse breakdown region operation is guaranteed. So this is the way how this is regulating. So whatever may be the changes in the input, if we can able to operate the Zener diode in this region, the output voltage can be able to maintain constant. So the current has to be flowing through the diode only up to this range. So in that condition, by satisfying that condition, we have to properly choose the RS value and RL value. Got it. And the next one is the regulation with varying load resistance. If the load resistance here, now the second case, Vin is fixed and RL is varying. If RL is varying, IL is also varying, but Vin is fixed. So keep here also the equation in mind. So what is that equation? IZ plus IL. At any instant of time, this needs to be satisfied. So in this case, if Vin is fixed, so now we are varying only RL. If RL increases, what happens? RL increases, IL decreases. So IL decreases. If IL decreases, there may be a chance for the total current I also decrease, but I should not decrease because Vin is constant. So I cannot decrease. So this decrease in IL is compensated by the corresponding increase in IZ, so that I remains constant. So that is the condition here. How long this IZ increases? Again, the same graph, till it is reaching the value of IZ maximum, it is increasing. And once if IZ is greater than IZ maximum, it cannot operate in breakdown region. So as long as this condition is satisfied, we can able to maintain I naught constant. And as the next one, if RL it decreases, what happens? See here, if RL decreases, if resistance decreases, current increases, IL increases. If IL increases, again here I may be increasing, but increase in the I is not permitted here due to constant Vin. So this increase in IL is compensated by the corresponding decrease in IZ. So IZ decreases. See here, IZ decreases. How long this decrease is permitted? As long as IZ is less than IZ minimum. Once if it is as long as IZ is greater than IZ minimum, once if it comes less than IZ minimum, it comes out of the breakdown region. So we can able to allow the decrease in the current of IZ until it reaches IZ minimum. So this direction you will see. Once if it is increasing, it increases till IZ maximum. So as long as IZ is greater than IZ minimum, so we can able to maintain the constant output voltage. At the end of this video, you got understood about how Zener diode is acting as a shunt regulator. And whatever may be the changes in load or source, how Zener is maintaining a constant voltage at the output. So keep on watching this video for the next type of regulator, transistor, series and transistor shunt regulators. See you back in next video. Thanks for watching.